There were some gorillas lifting weights in the gym. Then three more gorillas came and started running. Now 17 gorillas are in the gym. How many gorillas were lifting weights? So that's the number of gorillas that were originally in the gym, the gorillas lifting weights. So how many gorillas were lifting weights? And they have this diagram for us. What is this diagram telling us? How many squares are there? There's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17 squares. So this 17, this is how many gorillas there are now in the gym. So this is the 17 right over here. How many gorillas there are now in the gym? How many gorillas there are now in the gym? That's the 17. Now there were some gorillas in the gym. Three more came and started running. So maybe these are the three that came in and started running. So 1, 2, 3. So how many were there to begin with? How many there were there lifting weights? So all the rest of these must have been there lifting weights. So that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. So 14 gorillas were lifting weights. That's the ones where I wrote the numbers in this purplish color. Then three more came in and started running, and now there are 17, and you see the 17 blocks. So how many gorillas were lifting weights to begin with? Well, that's the 14. That is the 14. And there's other ways that you could have done this. You could have said, okay, there were some number of gorillas that were lifting weights in the gym. Now three more gorillas walk in, and now they're now going to be 17 gorillas. So you could say, okay, something plus 3 is 17. Or you could say 17 minus 3, minus the 3 that walked in. Well, that's going to give you how many you originally had. And either way you think about it, you are going to get to 14. 17 minus 3, you could view that as, well, this 17 is 110 and 7 ones, so you take away 3 ones. 7 minus 3 is 4, so 17 minus 3 is going to be 14. Let's do another one of these. And this is more of what you might see on Khan Academy, and it's good to just know what they're asking for. So this says, I bought a bag of 13 mini chocolate chip cookies. My sister ate some of them, and I was left with 8 cookies. How many cookies did my sister eat? So I had a bag of 13 cookies. My sister ate some of them, so those cookies are going away. So I'm going to subtract those cookies. So my sister ate some of them. So that's the question mark. How many cookies did my sister eat? She ate some of them, and then I was left with 8 cookies. So 13 minus something is equal to 8. Or you could view this as, if you want to solve for the something, you could say that 13, and some of you might just be saying, okay, I know 13 minus 5 is equal to 8. So you would know that the question mark is equal to 5. Or you could say that 13 minus 8 is equal to question mark. Or you could even say, well, if I was left with 8 cookies, and my sister ate some of them, so this is what I left with plus the ones that my sister ate, that must be how many cookies I originally had. So any way you do it, you get your question mark is equal to 5. Sister ate 5 cookies. Now they ask us which choices can help you solve the problem. Well, all of these, now we know the question mark is 5. We know that 13 minus 5 is equal to 8. So let me write that down. Let me just replace this with a 5. So 13 minus 5 is equal to 8. Well, that's a true statement that's describing what just happened here. So this could help me. Or actually, not that one. That's 13 plus 5. 13 minus 5 equaling 8. That's this right over here. And that is a useful thing to know because, look, if I started with 13 cookies, my sister ate 5 of them, I'd be left with 8. Now, what about this one over here? 13 minus 8. Well, we know this would be equal to 5 now. But they don't have a 13 minus 8 equals 5, so we don't have to select that. And then here, we now know question mark is 5. So 8 plus 5 is 13. 8 plus 5 is 13. That's useful too. Because we know 8 plus 5 is 13. Then we know what I'm left with plus what my sister ate is 5 is going to be the 13 that I started with. 13 plus 5 equals 18, not so useful. 18 has nothing to do with the problem. There weren't, you know, somehow, it's not like my sister somehow baked 5 more cookies and added them, and now I'm left with 18 cookies. I'm left with 8 cookies now. And so I didn't add the 5, she ate those cookies. So I would subtract them.